Hello friends, I'm Sarita Dash. I'm into teaching professions. I'm taking classes of communication, soft skills and self-motivational classes in different institutions and government offices. As you know friends, that you are having upcoming recruitment of TAV. So today I'm going to acquaint you with different techniques that will be helpful to you in preparing for your interview. And because I am speaking about my experience, I have experienced a lot of interviews and I have been an interviewer in a lot of sessions. So today I will share my experiences as well as what is a universal scenario of interview. First of all, you have to know the difference between the preliminary sessions and the interview level. So what happens, depending upon your institution, you may have 2 or 3 rounds. Or 4 rounds depending upon the institution that you are applying for. Let's say the preliminary round may be of a written test and ultimately the final round is the interview session. So basically what happens in the preliminary round, you may not have the opportunity to show your talents because there are many candidates who are coming to this round. So the opportunity to show your talents or your talents get reflected in your interview round. So the interview round is very crucial. So let us quickly know about the tips of the interview that will be helpful to you. First of all, we will be talking about addressing sense. Whenever you are going to the interview, you should be very much aware about what dress you should wear, because as a teacher you are a role model for your students. So the dress that you should wear, that should be very much sober and formal. Like, you should be very much comfortable in what you are wearing. Less jewelry, you should use less jewelry, and even if you are using your shoes, that should not be too much of showy. Studs should be avoided, tattoos should be avoided, all these things. There is a separate lesson that I'll be doing for you about dressing etiquette. The next thing, you have to arrive early to your interview venue. As you have no six, we have told that you can afford to come 3 hours before, but you cannot afford to reach 1 minute late. You must have sense sometimes that when you arrive late somewhere, what happens? Your self-confidence level decreases. You feel very much eager to know that what everyone is feeling about us. So it's better to reach half an hour or 1 hour before, so that what will happen, you will talk to the different applicants and you will feel comfortable of yourself. The next thing, you have to research about the school ahead of time, because there are many questions related to why you want to join our school. There are many schools in this area. So what happened, I want to tell you that you have to research ahead of your school. So what happens when you know about the school beforehand, the interviewer will think that yes, you are already attached and you are already connected with the school. It will carry a very good impression in the mind of the interviewer. So you should know that where the school is situated, then what is the vision and mission statement of the school, then what are the different policy of the school. And what happens, it creates a very good impression in the mind of the interviewer. The next thing is that basically what happens when we go to interview or any formal meeting, we feel very stressed. Before one night, we don't sleep or we don't eat properly so that we can reach the venue in time. But don't do that. This is a very negative thing that you are doing for yourself. Whenever you are going for an interview, you should take a very good night's sleep before one day, and you should eat something so that it will reflect in your face. You should not look tired and weary. The next thing, that you have to show off your social skills and maturity throughout the interview. Like whenever you are coming in, you should know how to knock the door, you should know how to sit properly. If they are entertaining handshake, then you have to make a very good handshake. Then while you are leaving your interview room, you should say thank you whenever you are coming in. Before they are, suppose they are not saying you to sit down, you should not sit down. You should wait when they are allowing you to sit. So all these are the things that you should take care of. And whatever questions they are asking, you should stick to your point. Let's say they are asking about your graduation, then you to stick your communication to graduation itself. You should not say a lot of things because they are also having less time in their hand. And you should also say everything logically. So what I want to say that you should show your social skills and maturity throughout the interview process. Then you should make a very good proper eye contact, because eye contact is also very much necessary when you will be actually a teacher, so that you won't look biased. So the same thing they are judging you in the interview table, you should have a very good eye contact, whether the interviewers are 2 or 5. A question may be asked by one interviewer. Initially you may see that interviewer, but the rest of the time you should see all of the persons who are sitting over there. Then you should be very much genuine and truthful. Suppose they are asking you that what is the reason behind that you have got a very less percentage in your plus two, then you should be very much truthful about it. You should not say what is false, because when you say false, what happens? We won't know. We might be saying that we are justifying our false statement, but there might be one psychologist who is sitting over there. He or she may judge by your statements, by your eye contact, or by any type of shivering false statement. The next thing is that you should be very much polite. Politeness should be reflected while you are shaking your hands, while you are saying, otherwise you are saying good afternoon or good morning, or you are saying thank you. You should reflect your politeness throughout your interview, because as a teacher, this is a very important trait, to be polite. And then post-interview is also very important. After the completion of the interview, you should not forget to say thank you, nice meeting you. Or if your interview is finished, then you can also ask for that mail ID, or you can collect the mail ID so that you can send a thank you message to the interviewers. So what they will think, it will carry impression in their mind. Okay, the person or the applicant is very humble, or is very formal, or knows the etiquette to say a thank you note. Then the thing is that what I can say that etiquettes are very important. Etiquettes of knocking the door, etiquettes of sitting straight, etiquettes of talking properly. Then suppose if they are, as sometimes what happens, you also face some types of stress interview, because as a teacher in the real life scenario, you will also face lot of stress throughout your professional life. So there might be some of the questions that can give stress to you. So don't panic in that situation, don't get angry, don't lose your temper. So you should know how to combat the stress questions. So don't get irritated any point of time. Suppose you don't know the answer, then very politely you can say that I don't know about it and I will research about it later. And another thing I can say that you should, what is very important, you should talk in a very natural voice. We should be audible, and we should be very clear, because as a teacher, these all traits are very important to you. Always you should talk naturally. What is a natural voice? You should not change your voice at any point of time, and you should talk clearly, and which should be audible. And what more, like, and I can say the most important thing, these are all the soft skills that I'm saying about, but the most important thing that you should have technical knowledge of your subject. Like suppose if I'm applying as an English teacher, I should be very much acquainted about my grammar knowledge. I should be very much acquainted about the history of English literature. If I'm applying for as a social science teacher, then I should be having a proper knowledge of the history, geography, and all the things. So last but not least, this is very important, that you should have a content knowledge. And friends, in the later session we will also talk about some important questions and what can be the probable answer to the questions, important interview related question. Till then, bye, and have a good day.